Christian Jonathan, Denmark. Service judge, Rich Martin, Singapore.
So we turn our attention to mixed doubles now, and this is the destination of Dubai ranking list. Five and six position changed positions after the French Super Series. Two pairs.
White or red?
How many chance on the French Super Series finals? White.
Serving?
Yeah. Is that what?
Who's receiving?
Nissan. Oh.
So Christian Johannessen of Denmark, our umpire, tossing the coin complete. And if you were with us yesterday, you would have seen Lu Kai, who's playing men's doubles with Kai Yun. Right now on the mixed doubles court with partner Wang Yashiong, up against a pair who've come through the qualifying, Yu Young Sung and Am Hae Won. Here's the mixed doubles draw, and look at that, at quarter final stage, six Chinese pairs, my goodness me, and look at the top half, because the former world champions, Tan Toya and Liana Nasia, losing their quarterfinal yesterday to a couple of 17-year-olds, Chen Shi Wei and Ching Chin Cheng. And here, Wang Yaoxiong, 20 years of age. And she and her partner, seventh in the world ranking, enjoying their third week at a career high of seven. But when the entries were done for this China Open, they weren't as high as that, and that's why they're not seeded. Making their first appearance here at the China Open as a partnership. 13 tournaments this year, two titles, the Malaysian Grand Prix Gold, and also the China Masters Grand Prix Gold. So to the Koreans, Am Hae Won, 23, and her partner, Yu Young Sung, 28. Now, as I say, they had to come through the qualifying because, as you can see, their world ranking 104, but they did go up 42 places this week after the semi-final place in their home event, the Korean Grand Prix, a week ago. Well, as you can see, yep, there's the qualifying match that they had to play against the Chinese pair of Ni and Tang. And then in the second round, beat the number six seeds, Go Sung-hyung and Kim Ha-na. And yesterday, well, if you were with us, you will have enjoyed, as Morten and I did, a thrilling quarterfinal against the number two seed, Xu Chen and Ma Jin.
What a roller coaster that was.
It certainly was, wasn't it? A thrilling match. They were 3-11 down in the first game before winning it, 21-19. They were 19-15 up in the second before losing it. It really was extraordinary.
It 21 was anyone's guess.
Yeah. 7 minutes of pulsating badminton. It really
did we guess? Or I did.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And I got it all
right.
Wrong.
Okay. Yak Wang Wang, China. And on my left, Yu Young Sung. We'll move on, Korea. Yak Wang Wang to serve to Yang Wang Wang. Level play.
So this is the first meeting between these two pairs. So no previous four to go on.
Service over.
Two of them.
One love.
We were emphasising yesterday. What a
two, love.
Yu Young Sung, we were emphasising that although the Koreans have had to come through the qualifying, that is totally unrealistic.
Yes, it's not a true
Service
reflection
over.
Of
one,
the standard
two.
Of the Korean pair. Obviously, they are so much better than you know, having to go through qualification to enter this main draw. And they have proved it.
Service over.
So, you know, I think after yesterday's performance and what we've seen in the tournament, they go into this semi-final as favourites, despite the fact that they had to go through the qualification.
Yeah, it is extraordinary that they've been in two Super Series tournament finals, the Koreans. Three finals in total, but two of them Super Series. And, you know, because they've had injury problems to Am Hae-won. She's been off the circuit, had time out. They've swapped some of the pairings around. And they have to go through qualifying, but rules are rules. And we were discussing yesterday that we can't come up with a solution to how to avoid that. Because you've got to go by world rankings, really, haven't you? For seeding positions and entries into tournaments.
Yeah, it's always, always very debatable. But in all sports, ranking is the key for everything. Obviously, you try to create the most reliable system you can, but rankings can never be a complete true reflection of reality. And as we can see, Dan's 14 on the world ranking. He's better than 14 on the world ranking, and so on. You know, you can always debate a lot of things.
I think has come about by lack of tournaments played. I think it's interesting, though, that our world ranking, that we only take the best 10 results. So players who have played 20 tournaments or so only have their best 50% of their tournament results counted towards their world ranking, which obviously gives an unrealistic indication of their standard.
It's over.
It does, because again, it comes down to what you talked about in the women's doubles with the Japanese, and what was it you called it? You had such a good expression.
A merit badge for effort, or
for effort? Yes, that was it. That was it. That was what I was looking for.
Yeah, no, it was, and that's a wrong expression because that's a little bit condescending, and I certainly don't mean it like that with the Japanese pair, because they're fine women's doubles pair, but they're consistently good without being world champions or winning the big ones.
Yes, but they are getting their semi-finals and finals.
Exactly, exactly.
The more I watch on A1, I get impressed.
Yeah, she's good, isn't she?
She is really good.
And it was such a shame, in my point of view, and I'm sure she concurs with me, that, you know, after those two medals at the World Championships last year, staged here in China, in Guangzhou, you know, then she had the injury troubles.
What kind of injury was it?
This is what I'm not terribly sure.
Okay.
I thought it might have been back injury, but I'm not terribly sure. And having been on such a high, a silver and a bronze medal from World Championships, she was the outstanding player in those World Championships last year, and she wasn't able to capitalise on it. But, you know, I described her yesterday as understated on court because, she doesn't... Oh, look at that. That's incredible. But she is a class player.
Yeah, that shot there, we actually got it. That defensive shot she made across court there was really, really good and very creative.
Yes.
And once again, it's getting the Koreans back into that rally. And now she's good. She is definitely good.
Umpire, Lizen, China. Service judge, Liu Yun, China.
Service over.
Apologises for his good fortune.
5-9.
Got a long reach.
Yeah, you might think this is a bit of an odd comment I'm coming with here, but I think some players can play a shot like that almost on purpose and get it over. I know it's a very, very fine line, but I'm telling you, some people can do it quite consistently.
I don't find that an odd comment at all, Morton. I think it's the same. These doubles players now practice to be able to almost get a net card cord, just as you singles players practice to be able to hit the tight spin net shot and make it hit the top of the tape and go over. I think it's the game has progressed to that sort of level where they're
11,
looking for that.
Interval.
It's always terribly risky, of course
it is.
But
you know, it's a calculated risk, and if you play it as sort of the top end of possibility.
Yeah.
No, it's a fair chance.
Yeah. Well, number seven ranked pair at the moment not really able to play their own game. That's due to the quality of the Koreans.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds. Eleven, five, play. Service over. 6-11.
Over. Yeah, and now I like that. That's nice.
12-6.
Apologised and really did mean it.
He did.
He looked and was concerned about her.
Yeah, but see, she'd duck in time, so no trouble.
Well, immediately, Yoo Young-sung appeals to the umpire because he is convinced that it touched Liu Kai on its way through.
7-12.
What did you think, Morton?
I didn't notice it, honestly. But I'm not close enough to judge it. But I would possibly have challenged it. And maybe one of the reasons why it was not going out on the baseline is perhaps because it touched it on the way.
Well, unfortunately, we didn't see that again.
Service over. 13-7.
Son's looking at his racket. I think he's actually broken the frame.
Yeah, I think there's a small chance. But that's a nice push, isn't it?
Oh, that's unbelievable.
With a broken racket.
They both had broken rackets. I don't believe it. There's the clash.
Yeah.
47.
Yep, you can see both frames are contorted there, both cracked and broken. How on earth did they win that rally?
That doesn't take skills.
Yes. You need a test shot.
Sung's getting to try 14, out his new racket. I don't think Haewon has got to try out the new racket at all.
I know.
14-7.
Seems to be no problem testing the racket.
No.
She played all three
15,
shots. 15-7. The serve. One, two, three.
Yeah. Thank you. Ah! 15-7.
Koreans at the moment just totally dominant in this. Missed it.
Serve is over.
It puts into it.
Yeah.
8-16.
I would have been standing on the baseline, you know, trying to get my bearings on that one.
Nine, 16.
Can't have been long by much.
It was.
Going with the drift.
Yes.
Yep.
Serve is over. 17-9.
Had a very good attack here by Yoo Young-sung. Not going cross court, but just keeping it straight and, you know, making sure that whatever comes back, should it come back, comes back to him. Good play.
Yoo Young-sung is already in the men's doubles final. We know that, don't we? Because
yes.
He and Lee Yong-dae, the first match on the adjoining court against the world champions, and the repeat of the world championship final, reverse the result.
Serve is over.
Yeah, I think Chin Bek Chol actually has to retire.
18.
They have lost the first game to 15 or 16, and then 13-7 down in the second, and then he had to withdraw.
Is over.
It's definitely
19,
one-way traffic at the moment.
Yeah.
10.
No, it's just wide. Well, the line judge hasn't made a call.
I know.
Serve is over. 11-19.
confidence, isn't he?
He is.
A little bit of trickery.
That's a confident shot. I
12,
can understand on
19.
That she's really quite disgusted with that shot. Played a good rally, but this one here, that's poor.
Well, if you're going to play a poor shot when you're 19, 11 half, I suppose that's a reasonable time to play it.
Yeah.
Service over. 20. Game point.
Very creative on
the
returns of serve, aren't they, the Koreans?
Mm. Yeah. Setting up 8 game points. In this first game, and here, how quick is
game.
That?
Only needed the one.
First game, one by Yoo Young-sung, Yong Hee-won, 21-12.
Yeah, there's some work to be done in the Chinese camp at this mid-game interval. No, not mid-game interval. Game interval.
18 minutes, some good rallies. The scoreline of 21-12 shows how dominant the Koreans were. So the players return to court.
Yeah, I think we're
Korean pairing of Yoo Young-sung.
Second game. Level. Play.
As the scoreline suggests, we're very, very good in that opening game, 21-12. Good flick serve, too. Start this second game. It's gone wide. And Morton, I don't know whether you've got a chance to see. I watched this Chinese pair in the very first round playing against the number 5 seeds, Mr. and Mrs. Adcock.
Mm. Of no, I didn't see
you
it.
Didn't see that?
No.
Very, very tight opening game, 23-21. Second game. They raced away with it, the Chinese pair, 21-8. And I thought at the time, because I'm big fans of the English pair, obviously I'm biased because I'm British, but, you know, I think that they're both quality, real mixed players, if you understand what I mean by that. And they got pretty much destroyed in that second game. And I'm sitting here and I'm watching this semi-final, and I'm saying to myself, how is it that this same Chinese pair who I watched destroy the world number 5 ranked pair in the first round, they're being so outclassed, but they're not being given the opportunity to play the way that they wanted to play or the way that they played against the British pair.
No, the Koreans are really playing good, and I think what they do is
add
on tremendous
pace
in what they do.
Yeah.
And I think that's upsetting the Chinese combination a lot, because I feel that Liu Kai is really finding it very tough to follow the pace. Mm. He's not in a situation where he can kind of command, take the initiative, win the shots in with a good attack as what he has got. He never actually get a chance to attack because the Koreans are just playing so fast.
Yeah.
See, that's
serve is over.
That return of serve and then the
three
next one.
All.
Oh.
Service over. 4-3.
By Luke Kai here. Very, very nice. Suddenly adding on a new complexion to this situation, I think, the way that the Chinese are getting much more into attack.
It's over.
Do about that.
No.
What a good shot it was.
5-4.
Yeah, that's well left.
Service over.
One of the rare occasions where Heiwan is playing a service mistake. She is a very, very solid server. Another broken string.
6-5.
Yeah. I thought for a moment that had hit the top of the table and gone over, but it didn't.
That would have been a little bit unfair, I would say.
Please put the handle inside. The handle of the back inside. Yes.
Six. Seven, five. Eight.
Well, I have to say, this is more like the sort of style that I witnessed in their first round match, the Chinese pair. Is it that they've just upped their game, Morten, or have the Koreans gone off the boil a little bit?
I think a little bit of both.
Yeah.
But I also think that the Chinese combination is really picking up here.
Yeah.
And they're getting better in their defence, playing more constructive shots in their defence. But what is the difference is they do follow up on it as well.
Yeah.
Seven, eight. Eight, all.
I think they've been able to take Hong Hei-Wan out of the equation for a little while.
Yeah.
She's not in the game as much as what she was in the first game. And I think that's a good, clever move by the Chinese as well.
Service over.
It's a hard man to serve.
Nine.
Yeah.
Eight.
I mean, that return of serve, I mean, it looks almost a nothing shot, but it's actually wonderful because he's just put enough pace on it to get it past the net. But it's nothing for Yu Young-sung to feed off at all.
He's got nothing to play.
Serve is over.
Yeah, that half-court shot didn't fool Yu Young-sung. He was standing there waiting for it. Quick man on his feet.
Play.
Whoa.
10-9.
Serve. Oh, it's cool. Good.
11-9 interval.
An excellent low serve.
And it was not for debate. No, no, I've seen that.
Yeah. You were talking about her serve yesterday, weren't you?
Yeah, she makes only one or two mistakes in the whole match. And she is serving consistently under good pressure, but still she can serve so well.
Yeah.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds. Play.
All six of the last 7 points to the Korean pair. And the momentum back with them.
Serve is over. 10-11.
Yeah, Wang Yaxiong, I think she's been far more proactive in this second game, Morton. I know that they've taken
Serve is over. One
out of the equation a little bit, but I think she's also become 12, more involved herself. 10.
It's so important, you know, for a man to have a woman partner that really is setting up good opportunities from the net. And the more active she is and the more opportunities she's giving you in order to go for these attacks, the better. And I think she's definitely picking up here in the second game.
Ten.
Now China really have to watch out here. I think the pressure is mounting from the Koreans, and they have to withstand that pressure.
Yeah, 9 of the last 10 points now to the Koreans.
Game is over. Eleven,
very good pressure added on to
12,
on hit one.
14. Change to seven. Shuttle is okay.
Very good judgment.
Yeah.
There we are.
Serve is over.
Once again, I thought the line judge was a bit slow to make the call.
He wanted to be sure.
Yeah, it's not a criticism, but I mean, I think as a player, you want a decisive decision.
Instant decision.
Yeah, rather than somebody perhaps thinking about it, or no, that's definitely now. He was much sharper there.
16.
Line judge.
12.
They do. Honestly, I mean, I know you've sat on a line before. I never have, but I would hate to do it.
It's so difficult.
Yeah.
It's not easy, I'm telling you. Cover by Yu Yun Song. That is very good cover.
Yeah.
17-12. Okay. Stay on the court.
Got a yellow card yesterday, didn't he, Lu Kai, for time wasting.
Yeah, but that was in the men's doubles.
In the men's doubles, and you noticed that our umpire here has just said to Lu Kai, don't leave the court. Get yourself ready.
I actually have a feeling it's the same umpire.
Is it really?
Time is over.
Yeah,
13-17.
Oh, we have to go back.
It's just glorious to watch.
18,
isn't it?
13.
But if I was standing on the other side of the net, I would say, how annoying is that? Beautiful shot.
Well,
19,
I have to say, from 5-8 down
13.
In this second game, this Korean pair have just upped their intensity. And now in a very commanding position, 2 points away from a place in the final.
Oh. What a beautiful shot. I can understand
20,
the disbelief in their
point
eyes.
13.
That was very well disguised. And that was actually one of the shots I would like to see Chu Qianqian use in the men's singles against him.
Game.
And this is the kind of shots I was looking for.
All rather fizzled out in the end, didn't it?
Totally.
Yeah. 21-12, 21-13. 36 minutes of play.
Match won by Yu Yongsung, Yong Yi Won.
And
21-12,
21-13. Tomorrow contest there. Third Super Series tournament final. Will it be third time lucky because they lost their two previous Super Series tournament finals? Well, we don't yet know who their opponents be, but
they're definitely looking for them.
Yeah. Very good performance by the Koreans. 21-12, 21-13. So just one more semi-final to come. Men's doubles, and therefore let's look at the destination Dubai men's doubles list. And I can tell you that all 10 places have changed after the results of the French Super Series, and back up to number one is Li Shengmu and Sai Chiasin, who we're about to see in the last of our semi-finals. Their opponents today for the Chinese pair, the number 8 seeds, Chai Biao and Hong Wei. Chai Biao and Hong Wei. Coming through a marathon match yesterday in the quarterfinal against the Japanese pair of Hashimoto and Hirata. In fact, saved a total of 7 match points. It's Li Shengmu and Tai Chiasin, number 6 seeds, against the number 8 seeds, Chai Biao and Hong Wei. Men's doubles draw. As you can see, the top half of the draw, well, that's already been contested, as you can see, and as Morgan was telling you, withdrawal by Shin Baek-chul partway through that second game. So here Chai Biao, well, he's been in a final here of the China Open previously, 4 years ago, playing with Zhang Nan. But he and his new partner, Hong Wei, played against each other in this tournament last year. Hong Wei, 25 years of age, Chai Biao a year younger, and as you can see there, win-loss record for the year translates